All right, I'm back here. Kind of got away from me last night, so I'm back this morning. Try to show you some tips here on my Photoetch. We've got my tools, X-Acto. These self-clamping pliers, or tweezers, sorry. File. Photoetch. Now I want to throw out one more little twist. Sorry about the music there. Again, forget about it. You have on the inside here your rooftop. They always put designs on it and stuff to show some pattern and everything. But the problem is they put these little pinholes where they use to get the mold injections out. Them are a pain in the butt to clean up and scrape off and stuff. So I'm going to give you a little tip that I came up with through Scale Auto Magazine a long time ago. Did an article. This right here is a foam, styrofoam plate. If I can remember where I put it. Okay, sorry about that. This is it. This is a styrofoam plate that you use for picnics and things. Turn around, you kind of get a rough copy where it goes, and then use a grit. This is like a coarse grit sanding stick, file, whatever. And you just shape it. Now on the edges, I bevel it to where it contours and has a little bit of a curve flowing down. And you do that all the way around, leaving this here high. I marked F for the front, B for the back, so it sits in there like this when you push it up in there. And with the styrofoam, you can paint it any color. This particular one, I'm going to end up doing the this is coffee. There's $2.99 for an 8-ounce bottle over at Hobby Lobby. Of which, the reason it's going to be coffee, that's the color of my inserts on my seats. Got my interior all done last night, got the steering wheel and things in. So going with a lighter color up on the top is going to reflect more light inside of it. So when people look in there, it'll be easier to see. And that's what you do. And you take it, you flip it upside down. You put the back. Now I like to write this on the side that's going to be glued in on the bottom or against the plastic. And you just drop it on in there. You use any kind of glue, Elmer's glue, white glue, and when you get it in there, it hides all that. So I'm going to go ahead and paint this. Now I'm going to do this as a brush paint it, and you know, put a pretty thick heavy coat on it, and then use a sponge to go through and kind of stipple it. And in doing that, it will give it a kind of a little bit of a fuzzy texture look to it. And you got to remember that the acrylics dry really quick. Now the cool thing is you just have to shape it so that you can still fit your windows in. And so this will go from the edge of the window to the edge of the window so they fit in there. And when you get it in there, I don't know if you can see, when glued in there properly, it sits up above. You can see it pop down there, I hope. And so you glue it up in there, and you can't see it looking in there. But when you look inside the windows, if you're doing shows and stuff, they look at that. And if that's not cleaned up nice and neat and everything, this is a very easy. It took me maybe 5 minutes to cut this out, sand and shape it a little bit. And once I got that done, just a matter of painting it, gluing it in. So just another little tip that I want to throw out there for you guys. This will actually go on later after I get everything else done. Coffee. Love it. Okay, we're going to go ahead and get started with the photo etch. Now, I'm only going to do a couple of pieces here. I don't want this to drag out. Not to mention, I'd like to have something to reveal after the whole thing's done later on today. I mean, pretty much everything's done. It's a matter of putting the photo etch on, the windows in, my headliner in, and glue the body to the chassis. And so, that's about it. So, we're going to go... Where did I put my little paper? Sorry. Right there. We will go ahead and... trying to decide what to start off with. You know what I think I want to do? I want to start off with some door locks. These are very, very, very teeny, very, very tiny. And I need my magnifier glasses. And I'm going to show a little trick that I learned in a workshop at the GSL show last year that really helps out a lot. Grab my masking tape. I should have set this up already. You take some tape, make a circle with it, on the same side, you push it down, and get it nice and tight. So that way, the tacky side is up. You can see how that's tacky. Let me locate my door locks here. Now this particular kit's kind of cool because it has little knobs that come with it. Part of the little knobs are for your radio control dials and stuff on the dashboard. Prior to looking this over, I actually went and drilled them out with the pin vise. And like I said before, I used the... pin heads off of push pins. So I went to some extra effort and work just because I didn't look this all over properly. But that's okay. Let me see. 15 interior handle knobs. 19. Trying to find out what ones are the... Where are the door locks? I'm not seeing them on there. And they don't show them on here. I want to get that started. Let me look this over. I'll be right back. Okay. Turns out, I ordered this here Photoetch kit. Has everything on there except for door locks. Only requires three. Two for the doors and one for the trunk. So, I went back to my stash, of which I found extra ones on some other... Photoetch stuff, so we'll go ahead and steal some from another kit. Get this crap out of my way. Now see, you stick that on there and that keeps the pieces from flying. One of these takes off, you're never gonna find it again. Guaranteed. Then I just used my X-Acto blade, cut it up. I do one at a time. I gotta get this to peel up. And there we go. Now I'm gonna take it with the knife blade and scrape it over off of the tape. I gotta get it to turn over. Come on, buddy. Come on. Almost. I want it just hung up underneath the tape. These things can be annoying. Well, the good thing is it flung up and landed the way I need it to. Now, this right here is going to be the trick that I learned. Again, I'm just going to use the window maker glue. It dries clear. You do not need very much at all. I use this needle right here, in fact. Burn that glue off. Now if you turn around and use needles and things, you can you get glue build up on the end to where it turns into a big ball. Use your cigarette lighter, matches, whatever, some kind of flame. It'll burn the glue right off of it. So, we'll go ahead and start. I got powder on there from when I was shaving my headliner last night. Use just a little bit of glue. Now this glue here, I pre-drilled where my holes go. I don't know if you're going to be able to see it. But I pre-drilled them prior to painting. Now I just stick the needle with the glue on it, which leaves a nice ring around there, plus goes down inside. Wipe off the needle tip. Now here's the tip. The best thing for picking up small Photoetch parts is your saliva. You get it nice and wet, and when you stab it, it'll stick to the end of the toothpick. And then when you move it over here, you stick it on there, the glue will pick it up. The glue's stronger than your saliva. Then you use the dry side of the toothpick to turn around, straighten it, and press it down into the glue. Now, there she is. There you go. See, and I still got to do my door handle and stuff. But there's a door lock. It's that easy using the toothpick. Now we'll go ahead, look at my picture up here. We will go back to the original one. And I'll do the rest of the door locks in a bit. Number 24, the Impala rear quarter panel script. Two of them. Gonna put that down. Use the X-Acto. Let's pull that off. Okay. Now, get the X-Acto to loosen it up. Now these bend very easy, so you want to go very carefully. Now this particular logo emblem is going to go right here. Can't remember what side my... Okay. Now this is a little bit bigger. Require just a little bit more glue, so and dab that. With just a little trail. Wipe that off. Then wet the toothpick up and over and onto the glue. Straighten it up. And there you go. Well, that kind of moved on me a little bit. Now you just got to let that glue dry. So there it is, right there. Now one thing, if you're careful enough, I like to use my hair dryer at a distance on low heat so it doesn't blow it off. This will help the glue under there set up a little bit quicker. And it doesn't take too long. There you go. Let's see if we can get that back into the picture frame for you. And there you go. That's on. Now, we also have number 26. Crossed flag Impala rear quarter panel emblems. Okay, let's go ahead and find the 26. You know, this Photoetch stuff is really cool to work with. Really brings out a realism in your cars. You know, it's kind of pricey and stuff, but I kind of made it a rule. Most of my builds are going to be box stocks, with the exception that I always do the plumbing on the motor, wire it and stuff, because that's detail that I can buy a lot of product and do a whole bunch of cars. But this Photoetch stuff gets pricey and things. So I plan 2 car kits a year. It kind of got buggered up a little. I'll fix it though. 2 car kits, maybe 3, depending. And I'll go all out. I'll get the Photoetch. I'll get the engine detail. I'll get the interior detail. And with using these acrylic paints, it allows me, you know, I think I paid $9.99, maybe $14.99 for this Photoetch piece. That one didn't come unhooked. So if I'm going to be spending a whopping $2 or $3 on my paint, from what the other paint systems are, that allows me to put a little bit of extra money, another $14, into the Photoetch. But if I had to put $25, $25 for a base coat, primer, and then rattle can or expensive automotive paint, enamel, lacquer, whatever, and then clear on top of that, you're $20-$25. That's the price of a kit. I could do this whole thing, like I stated many, many times, for approximately $3-$4 in material, and that's a whole entire car. So why not go and spend you $10-$15 and get a Photoetch kit for a couple of them? Most of them, I just build them, throw them in the box they came in, like this one here. There's the box. As soon as I get this done, it's going to go into the box. I'm going to wrap a bunch of paper towel around it, and it's going to go in my cupboard. Don't have a display place for it or anything, so until I can get that stuff to where I can display them, put them in there to protect them. So you don't have to go all out on every model, but it is fun to occasionally turn around and go and put a little bit of extra money or work or effort into it. I'm going to hurry up and wipe this down. You know, if you want to build a show car to go and show off at your model club, or to take to the local hobby town show that they do twice a year. Mine's coming up on the 27th. It's worth putting a little bit of extra money in it since you save so much on the paint. Make sure it's nice and clean. That's straight. That's already fixed. Perfect. And so you're able to do little things like this just to kind of make it a little bit neater. Now, I'm going to go ahead, add my glue right in the center. Again, doesn't need to be much at all. Just a little dab. Set that there. Wet down my... Now, if these are a little bit bigger, you could take it and go sideways with it, so that it picks it up. I don't know if you'll see that. There you go. And it's the same thing. Once you get it on there, kind of position it. Try not to mess with it too much. But you want it to sit flat. And that's kind of one of the things I like about the toothpick also. It will show you a nice straight line. Okay. Press it down in there just a little bit with my finger. And it actually looks good. Again, grab onto the hair dryer. I'm going to actually let this be the last piece I'm going to show you, but I want to show you a little detail that you can do with this. Get my paint. Give me one sec. Okay. I'm sorry, I forgot I was going to show you guys this. On these emblems, on the Chevys, they use a red and they use a blue on the flags. And is what I like to do is take these folk art. This one here is a metallic bright red. And then you got your sapphire blue metallic. It's the color I did my Corvette in. And because of the nature of this, and I have quite a few little emblems and things that I want to do, I'm going to make up just a little bit extra. So, that's more than I wanted though. Good thing this stuff is cheap. I can afford to throw it away. Now, we're going to go ahead and really dilute this. And again, I'm using my floor polish. Where did I put my brush? Let's see if this one's going to be thin enough. Really get it going in there. Mix it up really, 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 really good. You see, I got me a wash. You can see how it just drips off a little shake. You can see how thin it is. It flows just like water. You know, and I'll be honest with you, I think I want it to flow a little bit better. So I'll add some more. And I am really diluting this stuff big time. That's still not flowing properly. Let's add a little bit more. Or a lot more. You really can't get it thinned. And this, like I said before, you break it all down. And make it really, really, really runny. And the reason that you do that is so that it'll flow. Now see the way that's kind of starting to drip now? And it moves down. You don't need it to be on these little tiny badge emblems. You don't need to make it really, really gooey. You still want the color to stay there. Let me dry off my brush. And where did I put my... Oh, there it is. Before I do that, I'm going to wipe this up so that I don't get it all over. Now again, this video is going on a little bit longer than I wanted it to. But I like to make sure I do things the same way every time so I get the same results. Once you get it practiced and rehearsed, clean your brush out immediately after you're done using it. Even if you're going to be coming back in 3 or 4 minutes, this acrylic sitting there on your brush for 3 or 4 minutes, and then you're going to go stick it in there, and then it's going to be hard and leave brush marks. Good way to keep your brushes clean is to clean them out. Now, you can see where I'm at with that. I'm going to go ahead and hopefully not put as much down. There we go. With the red. And these metallics look really good because it kind of gives it a shimmer. This will work out good because I didn't use nowhere near as much as I did on the other one. There we go. Hurry up and get this one mixed up. But I didn't want to pre-mix this and stuff. I want to show you guys how I do it. The way it's supposed to look. And it has kind of a pinkish hue to it, but it is a bright red once it dries. Now, look at this. See how it just slowly kind of dripples down? That one there had a lot. Look at that. That's how you want it. Oh, did I just have this sitting right here in front of you guys? I apologize. Here, let me show you again. See how it kind of sits there just runny? Boop. That's how I want it. I don't want it to where it runs too much down to the bottom. Because like I said, it's just a very teeny, tiny, tiny spot. that cleaned off. And I got quite a few emblems on this. It goes on the hood, the trunk, the all the way around. I don't need a big brush, so I'm going to get this one here. I'm going to go ahead and moisten it up and kind of just damp it. And I'm going to go ahead and start by taking off my glasses and putting on the magnifiers here. Okay. I don't know how well you're going to see this, but hopefully the effect when I'm done. I'm going to load up that red brush. And I'm going to just touch it. And just by touching it, I might have too much on there now. It allows, you don't even need to hold it on there. There we go. See, you might not be able to see that. I don't know if that's going to zoom in, but it leaves a red hue to it, which just turned that flag red. When I get this done, as I show my final video and stuff, you'll be able to notice it a little bit better at that point, for the fact that I'll have more light and everything on it, and it'll be dry. I'm going to do the same thing to the other flag, just tap it. Again, let's try, I mean, I hope. Red and blue flags. Now, on your molded in emblems, you're able to do the same thing. Just use your a silver chrome paint, a Sharpie, because it's just the outside edge that's going to remain chrome or shiny. You could do bare metal foil or the aluminum foil like I showed in my previous video. And do this kind of a mixture and then just dab it. And then get the color on there. You don't even have to shave the emblems off like I did. The only reason I did is because I spent a little extra money to get this thing, and I bought this kit 2 years ago, year and a half ago, back when I was working, realized, you know, thinking, okay, I've got some fun here, some extra money, I'll go ahead and go all out on this kit. Wasn't planning on it being a tutorial kit, but it turned out working out really good. So that right there is my tutorial on how I do my Photoetch, how I do the, I'm going to sit this on my bed here so that my dog can kick it off and get my blue and red all over the place. So that's my tutorial on doing my panel lines. Again, you can see how they've shown up really nice. Doing my Photoetch, got my two pieces on there. I've got a lot more Photoetch to put on this and stuff, but just cheap, inexpensive ways to kind of really make these things look good. When you're doing your own, leave the scripts on there and use this little technique. Now, after this dries, where was it over here? Almost dropped it. That would be horrible right now, wouldn't it? So once you get that done, I'm going to go in there and I'm going to put a dab of Future over the top of that just to give it that kind of a glassy plastic look like the actual emblems. And it'll leave just a little shine over it to look like there's a little, one of the little plastic clear covers over the top. I do that on all my blinkers and everything like that. So I hope that helps. I'm going to go ahead and end this tutorial now, and the next update I do on this will be a final reveal of the completed kit. Hopefully I'll be able to get the rest of this stuff together on there today, and later tonight post the reveal kit, if not tomorrow. So I appreciate everybody for tuning in on this series that I've done with the acrylic paints, the floor polishes, and my Photoetch, polishing them out and everything. And if you guys have any questions or comments, please, down below. Thanks to all you guys that are watching and subscribing to me and following me and stuff. Got some great people out there. Nelson Manderos, I think his name was, just showed me a video that he did of some test shots with some of this, using my technique on the acrylic paints and the floor polish for the clear, and really come out nice. I mean, granted, they're on spoons, but you can't get a prettier spoon than that. So, Nelson, good job. Other people on Facebook pages are showing their first attempts, and it's all coming out working smooth and pretty and clean. And so far, I've gotten a lot of people saying, hey, I tried your thing, and it worked out really good. So, your techniques and your paint system. And so, hopefully, I'm able to bring new ideas to people and new ways of doing stuff to help save some money and be able to build two, sometimes three kits for the price of the paint for three kits. So with that said, I appreciate it. Chris Chapman here, and you guys all have a great day. Bye.